a great honor for me to bring a small piece of respect and love which Central Asian peoples, Uzbek and Tajiks, feel for Amir Khusrow and his poetry. We can see that Amir Khusrow Dehlavi always drink from already, well, maybe it was crystallized in everywhere in Persian world. So he bring it into Indian world, or it was of course वही musicians जो उस इलाकों से आते थे, तो वे लोग अपने साथ अपने ही मुसीकी और अपना वो सारा aesthetics भी लाते थे. तो ये बहुत एक natural चीज भी है, क्योंकि आजकल भी वो forms जो यूरोप से हम borrow करते हैं, तो हम उसको यहाँ बदलते हैं, जैसे यहाँ अपनी तरह से बदलते हैं, अफगानिस्तान में अपने तरह से और सेंट्रल एशिया में दूसरी तरह से. तो पुराने ज़माने में भी यही बात होता था. और इफ़ वी सिंग दैट इन ओल्ड टाइम ओल्ड कल्चर्स वॉज़न्ट वेरी लोकेटेड, इट्स ऑफ कोर्स नॉट ट्रू, बिकॉज ओल्ड कल्चर्स वॉज ओपन फॉर अदर कल्चर्स एंड इट्स वॉज in this region, it was always interrelations. You, of course, know this Yaman Vasanti, which are very popular these days. Other one, it is Sazgiri. Sazgiri, in all manuscripts, it's claimed like it is Purbi. Which was mixed with Gaura or Ganakali or Maqam, Persian Maqam. But they are only in Rag Darpan it is given that it is maybe Persian Maqam Iraq. Iraq, it is one of the main and old Maqams between 12 Parda or Maqams, which are main. And here in Iraq, Sazagiri is in Tal Firudas. This Jinki Kaam Hui Asan, it's very popular. One more maqam which was composed by Amir Khusrow is named Zilaf. Zilaf, everywhere it's named this, it is Khatarak, but with which Persian raga it was actually mixed, nobody can give it. Now, if we look to musical instruments, so then we can see that actually Delhi Sultanate was promoting mostly in Darbar. It was promoted mostly Persian music. So that's why Persian musicians were welcomed. And in poetical works of Amir Khusrow Dehlavi, you can mostly saw the names of Persian musical instruments like chang, nai, daf, or others. And he claimed as an inventor of sitar. Yeah, but some people wrote that in India, they wrote that sitar was invented by other Khusrow who live in 18th century. And there it's an ancient illustration. It is from Ayrtam, and this is from Buddhist temple. Was recovered. It is five musicians like Pancha Mahashabda, and one of the musicians played this musical instrument. This is chang, which are oftenly a term which are oftenly we can see in poetry of Amir Khusrow Dehlavi, and even Rumi. In his Masnavi also he mentioned a chang, because for Sufi people it was not only musical instruments, it was also some kind of how Sufi or we must come before God, because chang is not straight instrument, he has little bit his head is little bit down. Amir Khusrow Dehlavi also wrote one Masnavi on chang. And also, it is interesting that he puts these all musical instruments like chang, nai, and daf, and also this definition of parda. I need to tell that in definition of parda, he told when kawwal gives this all parda. When Kaval sings all this parda, so he not gives to some professional musicians of the court, but all this situation with musical instruments he put under coverage of when is Saqi, before it is definitions of Saqi, who is God himself, yeah? And after the definitions of wine, what is truth, yeah? It's not wine, but in Sufi philosophy it is truth. And when Saqi give you wine, and definition of this vessel in which Saqi gives you this wine, here is Nai, one of the mysterious musical instruments, actually. He's a musician from Central Asia, from Uzbekistan, and he is playing Central Asian Nai.
Thank you.